consider myself to be a pretty personal in the subjects I choose are not driven by market forces. That's why possibly most of the films I do don't work very much, are not blockbusters. I'm lucky that I choose to make subjects that are pretty personal to me. So in the case of when I decided to Kalona was because at that time I couldn't understand why Bollywood had an obsession of treating death with so much. Why we made such a big deal about it? I mean, possibly that's something that I have always, because of my chemistry background, my science background, my mother passed away on Saturday, I was at work on Monday. I chose to do Kalona because I felt we should celebrate life. And death is just part of that. So I remember Shah Rukh telling me when he heard the last scene that we were going to shoot, when I finished writing it and narrated it to him, he told me that, "But ye toh death scene hai hi nahi. Death scene, Devdas ka death scene hota hai. What is this?" And he said, it's not a full stop, it's a comma. I said, yes, because for me, death is just a comma. There's so much more after that. Possibly. I don't know. I was reading a study that day that where a top neurosurgeon in the world has said that there is afterlife. He has figured it out by science. It's quite interesting. Check it out. So I choose things that are very personal. Salamesh, I did. Again, very personal because nobody believed I had made Kalona. Everybody thought Karan Johar made Kalona. So I said, you all think I can't make one love story, I'll make six love stories. So it was out of arrogance, it was out of youth, it was out of brashness. In retrospect, Salame should have been four love stories. Salman always said that he should have played Akshay Khanna's role, Akshay should have played John's role, we should have thrown John out, and we should have thrown the Anil Kapoor track out, it should have just, but I said, but everybody thought Sohail should be thrown out. He said, but wo mera bhai hai. We could have kept him. So yeah, I think that, the reason to do Salamesh was out of some kind of a personal vindication that I was seeking at that time. And then I chose to do Chandni Chowk to China again, which was very personal because I felt, I had made a major flop with Salamesh. I have to give a very big hit. So you come out of some kind of arrogance again, which says that, yeah, the audiences want rubbish, I'll give them rubbish. But while making Chandni Chowk, I realized that it was quite interesting working with Akshay Kumar, and I worked with him three times again after that. And the ability to do the first possible big budget martial arts film, I think that the action in Chandni Chowk is quite compelling, it's quite fantastic, even today. And I think that today, I think the second half is rubbish, first half is superb. But I think that, so the second half, I remember a gentleman called Prayagraj. Do you all know who Prayagraj is? You all should know. If you all don't know, it's shame on you. So Prayagraj is a guy who wrote all of Manmohan Desai's films. I think what Prayagraj told me, which is very interesting, he said, all you guys are big, all of you all say that you all are making a tribute to Manmohan Desai and you all are so enamored by Mr. Manmohan Desai's screenplay and his moments and his so-called tricks. Manmohan Desai had a lot of tricks in his screenplay. And he said, but none of you all see the mathematics of the screenplay. Screenplay it's written with mathematics, which is ki if you've seen Amar Akbar Anthony, have you all seen Amar Akbar Anthony? Yes. So in the beginning of Amar Akbar Anthony, Pran Saab is Jeevan's driver. And Jeevan spits on his shoe and tells Pran to clean it. In the climax, Pran does the opposite. He spits on the shoe and tells Jeevan to clean it. He said that never happens in Chandni Chowk. At the interval point, you have such a big interval point where Akshay's mama, Mithun, is killed and the villain urinates on Akshay.
Yeah.
He must urinate again on the villain. That's my vindication. That's your setup, that's your payback. 71-year-old man, he didn't know me, he just called me out of the blue. And to me, he said it could have been a classic film. You all just ruined it. So I learned a lot from him and from that one conversation. Hopefully I have not repeated that. But to come back to your questions, I always choose things which are very personal to me. And there are very personal reasons for doing it. Patiala House, which came after Chandni Chowk, was a story of a guy who's looking for a second chance in life. That's what I was looking for. That's why that attracted me to the film. That's what I chose to do. When he came to Delhi Safari, two things happened. One, while Salamesh was being made, and that's why Aisha plays the role in the Hindi version. Aisha's father came to me. He's a big Nishit Takya. He's quite a big champion of animation. And he was starting a small animation outfit out of Pune called Crayon Pictures. And he said that, listen, rather than me going to everybody and asking them to see my work, I'd rather create my work. Will you do a film for me? I said, yeah, why not? Great, let's do it. Good idea. Why not? Plus, in 2006, my daughter was there, born. And I felt that by the time she's there, they had told me, 2 saal lagega. A good animation film takes 2 years to make. So I said, she'll be two, at the age of two, she'll be able to watch the film. But the first film she'll watch will be an animation film made by me. So that was the reason I chose to do Delhi Safari. It took 7 years to make. But I was just not happy with the animation. We kept doing it again. I was not happy now. We kept doing it again. Not happy. We shot the entire film on green screen. Entire film. All the actors were shot on green screen so that we knew how they were walking, talking, how they interacted with each other. So we did a 5-day workshop in Mehboob Studio. We put up green everywhere. We didn't have all that footage. We didn't have to use. We just did it for body language. This. Then they dubbed the film. Then the animators animated it. Then we call them again to dub it again. So it took about 7 years. So yeah, I made the film for my daughter. Also, it's a story of animals that are going to Delhi from Bombay to tell the Prime Minister of India that why are you screwing around with our home? How do you make it in live action? I'm somewhat of a environmental lover. I'm a Bombay boy, but I think that I love walking around parks and nature reserves and that. So it's again a subject that appealed to me. As a filmmaker, you grow up in Film City. There are times when you'll be shooting in Film City and suddenly in the night and you'll see leopards walking across, panthers walking across. That it always bothered me that we are encroaching upon their space rather than the other way around. So that's why I decided to make it as a film, which is an animation.